All right, guys, they're lagging for the break. Rafael Martinez versus Stenstrud, I believe is his last name. I don't know his first name. I'll try to find it out real quick for you guys, make it a little easier on my life and yours.
Kentucky.
Hey, you know this player's name down here?
Reed.
That's his name, Reed? What's his last name? He's pronounced it Stenstrud or something like that.
I heard it. I heard it before. I said, "That's not retard."
I don't know if I can get away with that on here.
Sure you can.
So this guy, you know Reed, right?
No.
This is Reed. He's one of the local players. He's starting to play pretty good. This should be a good match.
Yeah, he just beat Corey Dool, right?
What's that?
He just beat Corey, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's showing the winners, right?
Yeah, winner's side. Is this a winner's side match? I believe so. This is a winner's side, yeah. No, it's one loss side. It says one loss side. See, I got it right here. One loss, winners.
Because he just told me he only won one game out of five.
Wow. Not too busy in here today.
Yeah.
I know, but... Figured people would be here to watch the good players, you know. Yeah, it's Thursday. You know what I mean?
Today's Thursday.
Yeah. So, you don't know what day it is?
I do. Sorry, am I taking your seat?
Huh?
Am I taking your seat?
Against,
played pretty good. Yeah, he played pretty good.
I thought he lost the way he acted when he got the seed.
Yeah. Well, I was busy chit-chatting and I missed what happened. But looks like this guy's got a shot, so. All right, his name is Reed Stenstrud. Playing Rafael Martinez. It's a loser side match, so it's a race to three. Your 3 p.m. match will be Brandon Schuff versus Francisco Bustamante. It should be a pretty good match, too. So, that's a good one pocket for you guys today. Player, you know, very creative and comes with some great shots, stuff that you wouldn't even expect him to do. You ain't drinking no beer? How'd you feel? How'd you feel when you got up? All right. I think I had about 10. 10 pints, and it was pretty toasty. Yeah, the next match is a winner's side. That'll be a race to four. So,
we live there.
Looks like Reed is up 1-0.
Who's winning the tournament?
Don't turn that shit off, dude.
Hey. Man, I'm at this big tournament, dude, and this phone. I'm in California. Yeah. I just woke up and I just walked in. My phone went off.
It's 1-1 now. One to one on the ball count.
All right, I appreciate it.
Looks like Reed's got a nice shot here. He can run into the balls and open them right up. Looks like he trapped himself into the stack here. I don't know if he can bank this ball or not. Pretty smart shot there. Didn't really leave Rafael anything to shoot at, so. He's going to take a look and see if he's got anything that he can shoot at. He might be able to bank at the three ball. Looks like it has. Ball count right now is 3-1, Reed over Rafael. This is your first game in the race to three, loser side. We're at the 4,000 out at one pocket, California Blue. Well, he's thinking about cutting this two ball, but I mean, it's not without risk. He's just looking at cutting the eight ball. Shot worked out pretty good for him. But I think Rafael can go straight through to the eight. He might have a lane there. He's looking at it now. The loser of this match will be out of the tournament. So it's.
Did you guys head back
home? I don't know. Did you even see a truck? Reed needs three more balls here. He's got a shot here on the one ball. He didn't get shape there, and maybe he's looking at banking the 13 ball now, but I think he should just protect his lead. He doesn't want to give Rafael any air, because Rafael will get back in this match real easily. Took a swing, and he doesn't really have anything good here. I mean, he could try to bank the 11 ball into the 12, but it's just a bad shot, I think, you know, but you never know, depends. He's looking at the table now.
It's not that busy here, is it?
No, it's Thursday, daytime. But it gets busy at night, like, you know, after 5 o'clock. After 5 o'clock, gonna get pretty packed, and then people get out of work and shit, you know? We'll see how it is this weekend. It'll be packed with people Saturday and Sunday. Real busy. Yeah, Scott's on the winner's side still. He squeaked one out against Mark Hang, Hill match. That was just before this, so. Only scratch. He's gonna probably concede this game. If not, you know, Reed's gonna just bowl an end in the kitchen, have an easy shot here. Just a nice straight in shot. You play? You mean 8 and 9 ball? I think a lot of guys do. Play 8 and 9 ball. Well, Reed takes the first game. And it's going to be Rafael's break. Reed, I've never seen him play, but he had just beaten Corey Dole before this match. So obviously the kid can play some. I don't know whether to call him a kid or not. You know, I don't know how old he is. But, he's up 1-0 for Raphael. So, this guy can play some.
What's the race to 3?
Yeah, loser side. Winner side's 4.
This one's the loser side.
Loser side. Raphael's made a ball on the break, and he'll be off to the races here. I mean, I like him to run out here. The 5-8 might even be wired here. He's going to look at it now. Play that guy song, Raphael. Maybe you do. Well, Raphael's up 3-0 in this game.
Yeah. Might be able to grind it out against him.
That's you. Go back to bed, man. For 36 hours sleeping.
How do you sleep that long?
It's a long time to sleep.
Sunday I can play, probably if it gets over early, maybe I can play for a few hours with somebody, you know, just to do something. I don't want them all out here. I hate that, dude. Me and Scott had balls around. I had drank about 10 points. Me and him had balls around like 5 or 6 games. He roasted me. I actually came close to him. I was like 1 ball away a few times. Him and John Henderson might play. John wants 10-5 away. That's how they play in Reno, I guess. Scott said, no, I could be 10-6, 10-5.
Good shot there. Got his cue ball over behind the 5. And not sure if Reed can see the 10 ball or not.
Yeah, I think it's, I think they're both losers. 3 p.m.'s winners. I think Scott plays at Freddie Boggs.
Plays who?
Freddie Boggs next match. That guy from Vegas, the older guy. Remember who Ron timed out? They timed out their match.
No, Raphael's up 5-0. He got a ball hanging in his hole. He is down 1-0 in the race to 3. Reed just gives him that ball, and I'm going to see Raphael and try to bank a ball here. He's always looking to do something offensive, and that makes it tough for people. Is going to get this second game and tie it up at 1-1. Just like that, 1-1, race to 3, loser side match. We're live from California Billiard Club, Mountain View, California, 4,000 out of one pocket. Tomorrow will be the start of the 10 ball and the end of the one pocket. I think the field's at around 100 players right now for the 10 ball. How's the audio and video out there for you guys watching? I guess so.
What are you drinking?
Just orange juice.
Just orange juice?
Yeah. I got a breakfast plate. Even a breakfast plate here is pretty good. Oh, yeah. You get sausage, bacon, eggs, toast, hash browns. He breaks balls and not a terrible break. I don't know if Raphael can cut the 9 or not. That ball, but he's gotten fortune for the cue ball to come around. Could have made that, he would have been in pretty good shape to run quite a bit of balls. Yeah, if he would have made that, he would have, would have been pretty good.
Yeah, he would have run the table with that cue ball, that's what he wanted.
He plays a lot of three cushion, I think. Three cushion billiards, I think he plays a lot of that. You know? He does a lot of shots. Like, that was a pretty good shot there from Reed, and I don't know if this three ball combination is on. He's looking at it now.
I can't believe how cold it is out here.
It's about 6-5, right? Yeah, it ain't that cold. It's nice out.
Raphael fired at it and framed it, and now Reed's going to come to the table and he's probably going to shoot the 12 into the 15. Looks like a good starting shot. And probably have the 112 next. Yeah, Jimmy's alive. Reed's leading 4-0. And the match is tied at 1-1, race to 3.
Chris, like a shoemaker, and then I just went in and asked him. I said, he's not there, and a couple guys were looking to get some work done, so I passed it along. Okay.
Yeah, he was over here with that guy, Chris, his buddy, the big guy. And he's like, oh, you know, I think Scott would play Freddy like 11 or 7 or something. I don't know, so I don't know.
I can't remember.
Yeah, for sure. That kind of nitty, right?
Oh, Reed's up 6-1, and Raphael's at the table, so he'll probably be doing all right. That ball, and Reed's gonna have to. I don't know if how much of the two he can see, if he can twirl it and bank it, or if he's gotta kick it, but we'll find out shortly. Raphael's going to get a few balls here. Cue ball go, and he landed perfect on the 3. We'll let the cue ball fly around. Oh, Raphael missed that ball. I was kind of surprised that he did, but goal count 6-3 in favor of Reed. Jimmy don't know how to turn down his manual. He knows how to check the cameras, although Colby's every 10 minutes. Looks like he's just gonna cross the five and run his cue ball down. Oh, he went for the shot and he hit it perfect. Nice shot there. Spin really took on that bank and he hit it real good. Now the ball count 6-5, still favoring Reed.
Doug, what's up, Taj? Colby's corner pocket. My buddy. My good buddy. Can't get that ball to turn over on the
third it straightens rail, right out.
On the third rail. It's impossible. Had me worried. I didn't make any mistakes. Everybody was worried. That's what my sponsor said. He was a little worried too.
Yeah, that's what I said.
How do you think I feel? I played perfect. It was 3-3. The guy broke and ran out. I broke and scratched, he ran out, broke and screwed me. What am I gonna do? I played perfect. I'm happy. I'm proud of myself. I made a nice out under the pressure. Nobody ever says anything about that, though, do they?
No, they only want to criticize.
They always want to criticize.
See, look what you did, Doug. You ran Scott out of the booth. Well, your ball counts 7-5 in favor of Reed. He needs one. He doesn't want to do anything crazy here, you know? You don't want to let Raphael back in the game. You've got to be very careful. He's got so much firepower and imagination, you know? He's liable to pull some wild shot out and steal the game away. Wow, Reed hit it perfect. What a great shot that was. I'm really impressed with his game, you know. It's the first time I'm watching him play. And he had just beaten Corey Dole before this match, and it's fantastic, you know. Well, Reed's on the hill now. Oh, 2-1 over Rafael Martinez. You're watching the 2012 West Coast Challenge from California Billiard Club in Mountain View. It's 4,000 out of one pocket. And tomorrow will be the beginning of the 10,000 at it 10 ball. Table here, and I think you can count on him running quite a few balls here, if not running out. So looks like we're gonna end up having a hill match. Hey Spanky, what's up, buddy? Appreciate you stopping by. For those of you out there viewing, if you're having a choppy stream, if you're watching the dual stream, you might have to pick one or the other, because sometimes your internet connection isn't gonna, you know, play two videos like that at once. So and make sure, you know, that you don't have all types of other stuff running in the background if you are watching the dual stream. A lot of things that can affect your stream and make it choppy. Yeah, with Windows 7, you can just drag one window to the left, one window to the right, and you got your split screen that way, you know? That's what I do when I'm, you know, or if I'm wanting to look on the internet and then watch the stream, I just split the two windows. Yeah, I imagine, Spanky, it probably is. And the windows are probably bigger to watch. To view it, so. Well, Rafael is leading 5-0. Reed's at the table, doesn't really have anything good, so. Wow, it was dead in the hole, dead in the heart, and just the eight ball kind of got in the way. Rafael's gonna look to see if he's got any dead balls, you know. I mean, it's possible that the 5 could be dead off the 13, I don't know. Or the 4 could go, I'm not sure. Oh wow, that's might cost him big time. He's got to spot a ball up. Reed's going to have ball in hand in the kitchen, shot on the 8. He'd probably get down on the... let's see. Yeah, he'd probably be able to get down on maybe the 4 or the 15. He's looking at it now, I don't know if they pass. Maybe the 15 does go. Mm-hmm. shot by Reed. He landed perfect on this ball. Now he's just going to draw back and leave his cue ball kind of where it is now. That way he has an angle to go into the stack. Maybe a little bit more angle. Doesn't want to get straight. You want to have that angle. Go in the balls and open them up. If he can open these balls up good, he's going to run out. Is this spread good enough? Maybe the combination's on here. I like the combination. He'll have the 13 ball next. Oh boy. Reed missed the shot and, you know, he's let Rafael back up the table. Ball count is 4-3 favoring Rafael. Rafael banked it long. Got it close. Reed might try to get this out, but you gotta be careful. You don't wanna lose a cue ball. Rafael's really just going to move the deuce here. Or not. Shot from Reed, you know, you just get another ball on your side and remove one from his. And Rafael's probably going to try to bank the two into the 12 that's there, you know, and move some balls.
Sure, I'm sorry. Pull a couple of them out, Lenny, so you don't have to keep getting down there.
Dougie asked where you were. He said he's been sleeping like a polar bear for, I don't know. I saw you sitting alive.
Said you were sick.
Alive. You were alive already.
Huh?
I said you're alive, so.
You were playing this, weren't you?
You don't fit in my duffel bag. I don't know how I would get you out of the hotel. I got wheels on it.
I wanted to see you were going to play. Who was going to play? Preacher Rob? Daniel just called you. Is that who? Are you going to play Creature Ron? Give him 9-7 or something?
How's the stream going for you guys out there? Yeah, coming in all right?
I thought Lenny said go ahead and play.
Yeah, Spanky.
What were they going to play for? 500?
Oh, you said that on the stream. You were talking about Jimmy playing Creature Ron.
Creature who?
Ron.
He's so full of shit. Don't listen to anything this guy says, dude. All this bullshit.
What was he? Who was he gonna play?
When was this? Was it on a live stream or something? Probably me and you were on there talking about Ron. He wouldn't play. He wouldn't play. You
know?
No, you definitely were. You were talking, but
the other money too.
Yeah.
You were talking, but you said Preacher Ron was on the stream chatting, and or something, and you said, "Come on down." Was it you?
Yeah.
10-7.
Yeah.
Or 9-7.
I didn't back out of it. How did I back out? You're so full of shit.
No, it was Jimmy.
It was Jimmy.
It was Jimmy. He was going to give him 9-7 or Ron wanted 9-7.
Ron backed out of playing Jimmy.
Yeah. Don't worry, Jimmy. I'm not going to play you. You don't have to worry about your act and getting knocked with me. I don't want to play. I suck. I don't work. Oh, my God. Lenny gives me 10-7. I should tell you how bad I play the game.
Pretty bad.
Yeah,
let
me give you 10-7. You suck.
It's true.
2 years of my life, though, so.
That's all I play.
Yeah, you play it, like, all the time.
Nah, I don't really play that much, too.
And you're around a lot of people that are good warm
boxers. You're around Freddie Boggs.
That's it. But he plays pretty good. 15 hours a day. Freddie Boggs.
What kind of sweat battle are we going to have on your boys' match?
Oh, there's
my
no
boys
sweat
match.
Definitely not the favorite team in the game. It's got to play for a while. I don't know.
Beat right. John Moore.
Huh?
Beat John Moore.
Yeah, but John Moore got on tilt because
he's a cheat. I'll put up 50 to 25. Do a little 2-1 action. No, you never count him out. It's only one race, race the floor.
That's true.
I've beaten guys in tournaments that give me probably, you know, 3 to 4 balls. I'm through it again.
He played
Billy's quarter
or whatever.
No, yeah, that's what Billy said. Billy said that he had a chance to win.
Yeah.
You know, the truth is this, and everyone knows this, Freddie obviously is nowhere near as good as Scott. Scott could probably give Freddie 10-6, 10-7.
Maybe 10-7, 9-7. We can't give him four balls.
I will tell you that it won't be an easy run out game.
No.
Because it's going to everything going on the table immediately. That's how it's going.
Yeah.
Unless, you know, something happens with the ball, something they're able to run out.
To pick up the screen?
OnTheRailTV.com.
OnTheRailTV.
Yep, .com. Yep. You got it, buddy.
Is this going to be the stream too?
Yeah. Now Chef and Bustamante are at 3.
I have no idea where they're, you know. People are getting frostbit out there watching the freezer. You don't watch too much of it. I get tired of watching.
I think I've learned a lot.
Yeah. But it's good for people to see that, you know.
I wish you could play that guy, Billy Silver, so I know if I can play.
Oh, you want me to just jump in there and find out?
Well, you play one player pretty well. Yeah. You don't need to jump up even. I'm like, you're crazy. It's hard. I don't
play
nobody even
a long time. I don't even know my name in the club.
That guy, that bad guy with his mic, you know him with the beard? From LIE, and he's like 7 foot.
Yeah.
I just gotta
not shoot my own shots.
Yeah.
I won't be able to play at all the time here because I'm doing this. By the time I get done, I don't want to drink beer or something. That's it.
I bet you
brought
your
cue. I did. Because I know, like, maybe Sunday, if it gets over early, 10 ball, maybe I could get a couple hours in with somebody. If it gets over before, like, 6 or 7, you know what I mean? I don't want to be playing and starting to play pool at midnight. That's crazy.
When do you leave, Monday?
Monday, early on Monday. I'm hoping to get a few hours on Sunday before. I got a good game on Monday. Good action. I can probably know what I want. I'll put it up my own.
You got a bunch of money?
Yeah, I plan. I probably plan at least 50, maybe even 100 games.
Yeah.
Maybe 50 or 100 games.
5 or 6 games, just throw it out there.
First thing I do is, you know, drop this ball down. We dropped it all day.
Would you play? Would you play me?
I'll ask for something, but if I don't get it, maybe I'll try it.
I don't know how he plays.
I think he plays better than me. A little bit. Maybe a few people told me it's a good idea. But
10-7, I need 10-7 for him.
No. But we need 8-7.
8-7? 9-7, maybe.
You guys would be a good junior. I don't think so. I mean, somebody who's not trying to drop. He was like trying to tell me, hey, it's an even game for you guys. And it's good action. I'm like, it's even action. It's a good game. I'm like, I send a player to go. You know, but when you're looking at some of these guys, you know, you see them making good shots and stuff like that. They play jam up with them. Not always, you know. I mean, sometimes I look good for a little bit. You know, a couple racks I'm playing pretty good. And then I come back down the roof and shoot them in the rim.
I don't know who else to play
with. Where's your Ed Scott action?
I really don't know that I could beat Ed Scott,
too.
You think so?
I think you have a chance. What's that? You're
going to try.
I mean, if I play a 20-30 a game, yeah, I think 9-7 is better. I think I play a little better than he does.
You think you play better than he does?
I think I could beat him. You know? I think me and him got into
the one. Is he still in the one?
I'm gonna ask. I might ask him to play myself.
Is he still in the one?
I don't think so. Okay. Not possible.
Maybe if he offers
9-8
or
10-8,
maybe.
Give it a shot. What's worth lose?
$40 a game, if we can play like a race of 3 for 100.
Yeah.
He might not want to, but I've seen him earlier.
I might ask him to find this in one pocket. Yeah. And steal your action. Well, it looks like Raphael needs 2 balls here. And Reed needs 4. This could be a dangerous shot, you know. It's tough to control the speed of the object ball, but he hit it good. I'm not sure if Raphael can rip this out or not. It might be better off just give it to the guy. But it looks like he's trying to rip it. He's going to put right hand English on it. Yeah. Good shot. Hit it good. Look where the cue ball's going. Got him right up on the 6. That's not fun. He might just have to dink him over behind the balls, keep him between the rail and the 6. Yeah, your 3 p.m. match is going to be Brandon Schuff and Francisco Bustamante. See me play? I can't even hold a cue right. Yeah, I know. Whenever you're talking, I'm paranoid. Yeah.
That was a pretty good shot. And I'm not sure what Raphael's gonna do here. You know, he's gotta be careful. Might bank the 6 and run his cue ball into that ball. Yeah, that's what he did. Uh-oh. Reed's going to have a shot here on the 6. Hmm.
But yeah, Reed's going to have a shot here on six ball. Ball count right now is 6-5, favoring Raphael. On your ball count, 7-6. Reed goes for a three railer and might sell out a shot here.
Reed? No.
That's pretty good.
Looks like he plays good.
Jimmy, you're playing him later.
No, you're playing him. It's like you play him. It's like, dude, I can't play him. That's what I like about you, you know, when you were coming up, you weren't scared to play people in news, right? You had to play.
Well, yeah. That's
what I mean. How can nobody
everybody?
Yeah. People don't respect you.
Yeah.
But you look at, like, I tell Jimmy, I said, you're scared to lose, man. You know?
You told him that?
Yeah, I told him all the time. I always say to him, I said, you're scared to lose.
You're scared to lose.
I said, that's the worst that can happen is you lose.
That's why people don't get better. People who are scared to lose can't improve.
Yeah.
The reason Bernie's gotten so much better over the years is because he's always playing me.
Yeah, even if it's cheap, at least he's still
28 games is fine.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Yeah.
Too.
you were playing Scott Frost yesterday. He's like, how much did you do? He said, nothing. I said, I'm playing for fun. He's like, yeah, you think you shoot pretty good. I'm like, he's like, I shoot terrible. He just don't trade out all of us. I shoot terrible. It was kind of just funny, you know? You know, they see, maybe see you make one good shot or something. Like, yeah. Okay.
You just keep calling in?
Yeah. Shot the spot shot.
Not as good as Colby's, but they're good.
I haven't had any. Give it a whirl.
See things so far ahead, you know? I like that. Left him the double bubble. Double bubble, it's hard to get on this tape.
I ain't even shooting. I'm not even considering it. I'm going for a 2-rail. Tough shot. I don't know how good he hit that.
He didn't mean to be.
No, he meant to make the ball, but still hit it. What could go wrong there?
Look how good he did that.
He did.
You're a Gucci bastard.
I feel the same way about you. But look how good he hit this one.
You are a goofy, goofy.
Rack of sausage. Well, we got a hill match here. It's the loser side, so it's a race of three. It's 2-2.
You're watching the 2012 West Coast Challenge from California Billiard Club. 4,000 at it, one pocket. Tomorrow the 10 ball will start. It's 10,000 at it.
Just keep trying it. Sometimes
yeah,
it takes
that's
five to ten
I was
times.
Saying, I'm rebooting, like, open, closing, restarting my computer.
How reliable is that?
Yeah.
Have you ever used any other service besides Houston?
I think I used a long time ago, maybe Justin TV. Yeah. I've been so long with Ustream, I'd rather just stick with it, you know? All the videos are there, you know, it's just easier.
Yeah.
I mean, it's pretty good. It's usually pretty reliable, you know? So.
Usually.
Yeah, usually.
I did a stream like sometime early March, and their servers went down.
Yeah.
Like all of Ustream went down.
Yeah. That
Wednesday
I've seen
night.
That happen before,
you know?
Yeah.
Oh.
Now that you're like, wow.
And I actually had to migrate the whole show to Justin.
Yeah, yeah.
And I had to get on each building everybody to come to Justin.
Yeah, yeah.
It was crazy. And then by the time I had half the audience back, Ustream went back up.
Wow.
We're going to quick few commercials here and we'll be right back. Your 3 p.m. match is going to be Brandon Schuff versus Francisco Bustamante. But first, it's Hill Hill here, so you guys got to enjoy this one. We're just taking a quick break. He'll be right back to the table. It's going to be the last rack for this set. It's 2-2, race to 3, loser side. But your next match is going to be at 3 p.m. Brandon Schuff, Francisco Bustamante. We're coming back in right now. All right. Raphael's back. He's got the break. It's Hill Hill. Between himself and Reed Stenstrid. Should be a... It's going to be an interesting game, I feel. In one way, but I think you're going to see Raphael bank this 15, and cue ball will just travel down table, and we'll have shots on other balls.
It's coming from this guy. You'll be smoking and drinking in 2 days. I'll try to get you to stop. 2 more days, you'll be smoking and drinking and chasing women. We're off the air in Reno.
Got to rip these balls out. Wow, he almost made it as well.
Oh, look at the cue ball, too.
Such a great game, isn't it? One pocket? Huh?
It's such a good game. Everything's involved. Everything's involved. Shooting, kicking. Yeah. Yeah, I thought I did under the pressure. You know, the way he came back on me without making a mistake.
Well, Rito's one there. He,
the five ball was
fouled.
The five ball, that was fouled.
What are you doing? I guess Reed's got to get a coin to put up so they keep track of the foul.
I told you what that reminds me of. I'm going to sit on the floor by the portal. The portal. But what I see is the
there we go.
Yeah, in case I don't make it. Because I only had half a pocket to make. I hit it as soon as I hit it. I didn't think I'd make it. No. So, in case I miss it, I'm supposed to okay. That left me a tough shot in my next shot. But I made that too.
He plays good.
Which internet are you on, Jimmy? Which internet are you on?
Which internet are you on?
I haven't even looked yet, but I'm sure I'm
on. The guest one? It's the guest one, right? Yeah, they shouldn't let you on it a lot. Sucking bandwidth from my live stream.
What's the rule?
I said he'll be sucking bandwidth from my live stream. Looking at his cameras, I told you. Who cares about it, you know? You get your... far away.
Are you
right?
Just keep, I agree.
Yeah, just come back and deal with it.
I agree.
I think he's paranoid. Thinks they're robbing him. They're robbing him.
How many beers do you
have? About right now, there's about 225. Yeah, it's early on a Thursday, so. I think. Maybe I streamed Scott and Efren, and at one time we had 1,000. But over
you add up all the numbers over the course of the day, like today we'll probably have a couple thousand in total, you know? And,
where was when he played where?
In Phoenix.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, and we had about 1,000 viewers the whole time. So we probably had about 10, 20,000 people who tuned in over the time of the play. That's pretty good, you know? So it's not too bad. You're going to be coming out there too, right? To Phoenix?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, when you want to get some more ink, you let me know. I got a good connection with my buddy. He does pretty good work. Like, he'll do a tattoo like this on me for, like, say, $50, $75.
That's cheap. So how much do you think each of me, I want, like a spider, like the, how you call it?
Like a black widow spider?
No, I want to like
a spider web.
A spider web. Yeah, or with a spider, with a web, and then with a small scorpion.
Yeah, I mean, he might do something like that on me for maybe $100, $150. That's cheap, you know, because it's a lot of.
Yeah, that's very cheap. This one cost me almost $4.
And he's really good. He did this one. He just did this one. Yeah, and then did this. Been working on, you know, just different stuff. This one I got in New York, it came out pretty good. Came out pretty good.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah,
man,
must be
hard. Oh yeah, it's painful. You got to sit there and just 5 hours.
And
not fun.
He just gave me the password, but I was kidding.
I don't know.
It was a walnut 48. Is that what you typed in?
I don't. Mine's saved from last year. I don't even know the password. Mine's saved from last year. Do you really need to watch that?
Sometimes I do.
You can do it when you're over in the room. They don't know when you're watching. During the day right now, ain't nothing going on there.
There it goes. Normal 3G, I think.
Yeah. They said you're robbing the bandwidth.
Huh?
Said you're robbing the bandwidth.
Emma?
No, but that's what they're saying. You're doing. You might be. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think so. That's a secure line, you know, a secure one. But if you're checking it once in a while, you know. Once in a while, it ain't gonna make a difference.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fish, buddy.
Well, this is gonna be an exciting Hill Hurdle match here. Raphael's got to get an angle here to go into these balls. Try to open it up. Wow, I thought he would go into those much harder than he did. He's left Reed in a real bad spot here. I hate being in this little situation here because if he moves a four, I mean, it's going to be tough not to leave a shot here for Raphael. See? He sold out and he's going to lose the set here because Raphael very well could run out. He needs six balls. He's leading two balls to zero, it looks like. So, that should be it. Fell on this, but unfortunately he hasn't really left anything besides this one ball. He's got a shot.
He's up 4-0. Reed's got a bank here on the one. If he can get up his cue ball, he'll have the 2-9, but he's going to go all out here. Nice shot. Reed's going to be back in it. This one we thought it was over, and we counted Reed out. He has a chance. And he's back in the game. He could actually play this.
Yeah, he probably could do that.
Gonna play this off the balls here. I like this shot. Maybe shooting it off the 13 or the 14. No, he decided to cut it. Got a shot here on the 14. These pockets are just a hair over 4 inch, I guess. And so I know you guys out there, when you see him miss a ball, you think, well, how did they miss that? But tight pockets. Five balls of three in favor of Raphael. Oh boy. Raphael's got a cut here on the 8.
He'll help.
Good.
Yeah.
His name is Reed.
Reed.
I'm not sure. I don't really know much about him. I think they're going to get started at 3 o'clock. A couple minutes. Yeah, there's two tables that they got going, yeah.
Carla?
Yeah,
you sent me something. Some
probably something, tables. Yeah.
I'm a hard time.
Oh, yeah?
So is this a race to 3 or 4 here?
3 on the losers, 4 on the winners. Yeah, this is the loser side. Huh? Not sure. No idea. Yep, and the tournament board's right over there. All the. Well, 6-3. Here's your ball count. Raphael needs 2, and. You know, they both had their chances in this game to do stuff, and left to, I think, Raphael can twist this 11 ball and bank it. It's like a slow spin with a lot of spin. No, he's just playing the safe route. He went around those balls. It could have worked out differently if he clipped it. Could one rail to six if he wants here, and maybe play to get on the 13, you know, if he can make the ball, or he just doesn't want to leave Raphael a shot, because Raphael is not scared to shoot. At least he doesn't show it anyway. He's trying to get his cue a little bit harder, and he got his cue ball back there, and that would have been, Raphael would have been a real tough spot. I think you just got to talk to maybe Chris, the owner. Sure. I'm not sure where he is.
I guess
I'll have somebody in my commentating with me.
Huh?
I'm gonna have somebody in here commentating. So
I'm the commentator.
Yeah. I'll just let you commentate a match. We're gonna commentate the next one.
I haven't done it.
That's easy. You just talk about what shots you think to shoot. Keep people updated on the ball count, the scores. It's boring. It's easy.
I don't know the player's names.
Sell out a shot. Ball count 6-4. We're not counting Reed out just yet, you know. I mean, anything can happen here. Especially with the way the balls are laying. Yeah, there's a lot of people actually spectating, I'd say. Because the room's so big, you know, and there's plenty of other matches going on at different places. So there's just a ton of them. Yeah. There's a ton of them, ton of matches and a lot of people in here. And it's only going to get busier as it gets later on, you know. It's 3 p.m. and, well, that could cost Raphael. Reed can make this ball and get down here on the 6-13. They'll be leading 7-6.
Slice that 10 in.
Yeah, come down. 10-6.
Yeah. 13-6. Don't have a high left on it. This guy doesn't play bad.
Nah, he plays pretty good.
Yeah, he plays pretty good.
Oh, he jacked up now.
He just cinched it to make sure he made it.
Yeah. Now he's jacked up. That'd be fun. Oh, ball count 6-5. Reed's jacked up here. He's not going to take a... Looks like he's not trying to take a chance. I don't know if he's trying to bank this into the point or what. He leaves him there and leaves him jacked up.
You can't bank that 3
close. He might bank it into the 15. Run his cue ball over to the left-hand side of the table. No, just play it safe. I don't know if I'm going to Vegas next month or not. Just thinking about going to visit friends and family in New York instead, but we'll see. The U.S. Open One Pocket would be fun to go to. Yeah, he's looks like he's lost 40 or 50 pounds. You're right. I don't know if he can twirl this three or not. That wire.
Why you can't touch it?
Because of the way it's plugged in through this.
Oh, okay. You're sabotaging Lenny's equipment.
Yeah. Yeah, right after this match is over, we're going to have Brandon Schuff and Francisco Bustamante next, so it'll be a pretty good match for you guys to watch. This match has been pretty decent, you know. Both players have struggled a little bit when they've had opportunities, but they've also came with some really good shots, too. Ball count 6-5 in favor of Rafael Hill.
15 goes, don't it? I can't tell from here, Harvey. It goes. Oh, I guess he's going to make it. Get behind those balls.
Well, Rafael, if he wanted to, he could try to bank this one rail, but I don't know if he's going to go all out and fire at it, but it's his style, you know?
He's going to shoot this too, brother, I think. I don't like it.
And he two railed it to his hole, and it's going to come down low, and looking at playing the 13 here. Yep. Played the 13. Good shot. He's got a bank on the 6 to win the match.
What a shot he made there, huh?
Yeah, he hit it pretty good.
He just needs one now, don't he?
Yeah, yep. He's got the bank here on the 6, and that should be it if he can make it. These pockets are a little bit over 4 inches, so not necessarily
easy. He almost scratched.
Wow. Good match, Hill.
Wow.
Rafael moves on. He's on the loser side, but he's alive, so. And good tournament for Reed. He shot pretty well. I was impressed with his game. So your next match is Brandon Schuff, Francisco Bustamante. Winner side, race to 4.
Boost the money's playing up next?
Yeah.